In the depths of the Great Depression, local farmer and cattleman Dave Bazanio and his wife Aileen built a spectacular movie palace in downtown Augusta, Kansas, a small community just east of Wichita. No expense was spared. The building cost $70,000. That's $1,250,000 in today's money. Upon opening, the theater was flooded with telegrams of loving support from Hollywood royalty, including Louis B. Mayer, Clark Gable, Jean Harlow, and Joan Crawford. The opening film, Black Sheep, played to a full house on June 19, 1935, an auspicious debut for this beautiful theater. For 50 years, the Bazanio family operated the Augusta Theater as a first-run movie house. They closed the doors in November 1985, and the building was left empty. Fewer than one in four movie theaters built in America prior to World War II survive today, and the Augusta Theater could easily have been another such casualty. But then in September 1989, the Augusta Arts Council, a 501c3 not-for-profit organization, purchased the theater and began the task of restoring and preserving this precious community treasure and putting it back into regular use. Designed by architect L.P. Larson, the Augusta Historic Theater was among the first in the nation to feature neon illumination not just on the marquee but throughout the building. Art Deco and Egyptian motifs dominate the decor, with abundant handmade plaster moldings in black, silver, salmon, burgundy, and seafoam, and a dazzling hand-painted ceiling covering the entirety of the 633-seat auditorium. Large tapestry murals flank the seating area, creating the feeling of a lush classical terrace with fountains and greenery. The building survived a fire in 1949, requiring some renovation. The current carpeting is a modern recreation of that installed after the fire. In addition to the movie screen, there is a stage suitable for live musical and theatrical performances. And in the projection booth, alongside the old Simplex Carbon Arc 35mm film projectors, still fully functional, is a modern-day digital projector linked to a 21st century theatrical sound system. The Augusta Historic Theater now shows a mix of first-run and revival films, and its low prices at the box office and fully stocked concession stand ensure its place in the community as an affordable family entertainment destination. Wherever you look, the Augusta Historic Theater meets your eye with beauty and splendor. Under the care of the Augusta Arts Council, a painstaking renovation has taken place over the past three decades, bringing all the spectacular architectural details back to life. But that process has required sustained effort, hard work, and substantial financial support from the public. The theater was placed on the National Register of Historic Places in 1999, and in 2003, local donors pledged nearly $150,000 toward its restoration, which was matched by a grant from the Save America's Treasures program. In 2011, a fundraising effort brought in enough to equip the theater with its digital projector, essential to its continued operation in the modern age. The latest project requiring attention is the repair of the theater's iconic neon marquee, which sustained extensive damage in a severe storm. As the very visible face of the centerpiece of downtown Augusta, and as a historic architectural jewel of our region, it is important that it look its best and brightest. So today we ask you for two kinds of support, financial and social. We are inviting contributions through this online fundraiser, but also hope those in the area will support us the old-fashioned way by attending our events. Regardless of your ability to donate, we ask you to please tell your friends, family, and coworkers about the Augusta Historic Theater on social media and everywhere else. There are nearly 650,000 people in the Wichita metropolitan area, many of whom are entirely unaware of the theater and its programs. Your word of mouth is the best advertising there is. With your help, we can work together to preserve the Augusta Historic Theater for generations to come, allowing it, as Dave and Aileen Bazanio wrote in 1935, to do the work for which it was created and contribute its full share to the betterment of the life of this community. Thank you.